Visual field abnormalities and the visual pathway.
So, visual field defects can be caused by damage to structures that correspond to what we call the visual pathway. And that starts in the eye, the back of the eye, where the optic nerve and the retina are. The optic nerve courses to the little area in the tiny little area in the part of the brain that's just behind the eyes, called the chiasm. They cross, half of the fibers go to one side, to one hemisphere, the other half go to the other from each eye. And what's happening is the projection of the left field goes to the right brain, and the projection of the right field goes to the left brain. And it occurs right after the chiasm. And there's a long pathway, actually, all the way from the eyes to the back of the brain, to the occipital lobe. So damage to any part of those structures can cause a visual field loss, not just in the eye, but in the back of the brain, all parts of the brain.
We see a graphic depiction of the way in which the human visual pathway and the various structures transmit and interpret visual information. A green apple is presented in the left visual field and a purple and white fish in the right field. Information from both fields enters each of the eyes and is projected to the retinas. At the chiasm of the optic nerve, half of the fibers from each eye cross into the opposite hemisphere of the brain and onto the visual cortex. The visual cortex of the left hemisphere processes information from the right visual field and vice versa.
So it's important to think about also what kinds of disorder, damage, or they sometimes we call them lesions, are causing these visual field defects at different levels of the visual system. And in terms of the most common disorders in the retina, it would be some kind of hemorrhage or some kind of circulatory problem or a retinal degeneration. I mean, they're not common in the world of visual impairment, but in terms of people's serious problems, it's a retinal degeneration. Also, there's diabetic retinopathy, which causes problems in peripheral vision and need to be detected. In the optic nerve, for optic nerve defects, the biggest problem is really glaucoma. And that's one of the reasons why the static perimetry is so important, because it's picking up glaucomatous field losses, that's what they're called, early and where treatment may be more effective. There are other causes of optic nerve lesions as well, optic neuritis, neuropathies of various sorts for all kinds of reasons. Children can have congenital defects of the optic nerve that cause field defects, and those are very important to find. One of the syndromes that of the children that we see here at Perkins is CHARGE syndrome, and there can be a loss of tissue in the optic nerve and also in the retina that causes a characteristic defect, field defect of the upper part of the field and maybe sometimes here. And those actually are pretty good, easy to test because the person doesn't see anything in that field. But generally, optic nerve and retinal diseases are hard to test. And in most children, they're very difficult to test. So in adults, you use automated perimetry and you do very well. Now, at the chiasm, when you have those crossing fibers, the most common cause of a visual field loss at the chiasm is a tumor. And so I see a number of little children who have tumors, and one of the really important things is to measure their visual fields, because they can give us more information than this tiny, tiny little area called the chiasm. Even an MRI doesn't give you the information that a visual field defect can give you. So then we get back into the, called the brain, but it's all the brain, actually, but past the chiasm, the kinds of damage or disorders that cause visual field defects in the hemispheres are stroke and tumors. And in children, some children can be born where there's been some kind of event that causes them to have low oxygen, poor blood flow to the brain, and they can have not really a stroke, but a loss or a damage to a certain part of the brain that affects the visual field. And those kids are really important to be able to do their visual field and find out if they have problems.
Fade to black.